Floral calendars. It's information adapt manual to your local specifications instead of spending resources to make new ones. And the last aspect of the evening exchange will be auto-moderated discussions. These are discussions on specific topics related to beekeeping, of course, which are moderated by experts on the topic, with the objective of clarifying some issues. Since the launch of the beekeeping exchange group, we had 25 moderated discussions on various topics related to beekeeping. The moderators of the exchange group, as I said, are experts. This year, for example, we had a moderated discussion on adulteration of honey, moderated by Etienne Brion. We had another one on methods for on-field diagnosis of honeybee diseases, moderated by the Italian Research Institute. And then we will have a moderated discussion on the use of beehive products and apitherapy, moderated by apitherapy expert. Now, where does the information that is available come from? The technologies and practices available in TECA are provided by the TECA partners. These are entities that generate knowledge or have implemented innovations for beekeepers. They include development organizations, for example, practices implemented through projects, research institutes and universities, for example, research outcomes, NGOs, beekeeping associations, and field technical units. The TECA team helps the partners to present the information in easy language and format that will allow beekeepers to implement these practices in their operations. We currently have 107 partners from around the world, but they are contributing to the whole platform, not only to beekeeping. Now, what are the advantages of TECA from the user's point of view? If you are a beekeeper or a farmer, you can find information that is presented in a non-academic, non-scientific language, with drawing and pictures to facilitate understanding. And very importantly, the practices have been tested by farmers before, so it's not only innovations, it's tested practices. Users can also find information that they are not directly looking for. A lot of beekeepers are also farmers, so they can also find information related to their other activities or innovations they are not aware of, but because their website they can come across these things that they don't even know they exist. If you are a registered member, you will also receive regular updates of the activities going on the platform. If you are a project manager or a researcher, for example, you can benefit from the work that is already done by others and avoid duplication or spending resources on something that has already been done. For example, the case of the beekeeping manual. From a partner point of view, so if you are a generator of information, websites are expensive to set up and to maintain, and in the case of projects, once the project fades out, the money is finished and the website is not maintained anymore, so the information is lost. So partnering with TECA is a cost-effective way of making the information generated through the project available for the long term. TECA helps its partners to document the practices and technologies, again, as I said, into a suitable format and a language that facilitates adoption of the practices. TECA hosts the technologies on a balancing platform and guarantees that practices are available in time. And we also promote the platform. So it's a way for the partners to have a wider outreach of their knowledge generated. And partners can also, through moderated discussions, present the results or share information. So the success of TECA depends on the willingness of partners to share the information. So this is an invitation for those who generate information to have a look at the website and contact us to share your information to the technical body. I will conclude with four little scenarios of where you see it, how you, the different partners can benefit from TECAM. Imagine you're a leader of a big or a community in Rwanda. Some of the farmers have also bees in the forest, and people come from the city to buy the honey in the village. But sometimes people from the city don't want to pay the price, or the real price for the honey, because they say that the honey is not clean. So as a community leader, you think, okay, I can help my farmers or my beekeepers to increase their income. I need information on how we can improve the production of the skin and honey. So maybe you go on the internet and you look for information and you find this wide array of information and you're not really sure which information you will rely on. And so TECAM can help you with information that has been tested and has been validated. Imagine you are a farmer in the Philippines and you read in a newspaper, newspaper article about deforestation and its effect on pollinators. You learn most of the article that stainless bees can be used to pollinate crops and to increase agricultural production through the pollination. So if you're interested in learning more about how to use you go on the internet probably, and this farmer here on the image, he comes across the TECAM website and he sees a moderated discussion on the use of stainless bees, and he finds all useful information on how to use the bees. He can find links to practices where they describe step by step how he can manage stainless bees, how he can collect honey and other products from the hives, and how he can multiply these stainless bees. And he also finds a link to a course being organized by the university in the Philippines, so he can also attend the course. Another scenario is a beekeeper, member of a beekeeping cooperative in Chile, and together with a fellow beekeeper, he has developed a simple tool that allows to extract residual honey from the residues from the vapor waxes sector. He has been using this tool for a long time and he can recuperate some extra honey and extra wax. And other beekeepers also ask him, can you tell me how to make this tool because I want to use it too? So this beekeeper thinks, okay, maybe other beekeepers in the country or in neighboring countries also want to know how to make this tool. So through a fellow entrance to a this is the last one. Through a young guy in his cooperative, he learns about TECAM, and through the association, he contacts the TECAM team. The TECAM team is helping them to describe this practice, and it is promoted and disseminated through the platform. So I would like to thank you here, also the TECAM members, our partners, and our moderators for the support. If you want to visit the website, you have the link there to do. If you want to share information with us, please contact us. Our website is there. Thank you very much.
We can take one question. Accessible manner for these beekeepers and trying to Timor-Leste. Some of them do have access to telephones, but I couldn't imagine any of them being able to access a computer. And if they could, even the internet at its fastest rate, I just see that it would be quite difficult for them to access this information. And also, across the languages, you know, in Papua New Guinea, there's 850 something languages, and to try and converse, you know, how to make a split or what a queen is.
Yes.
That was the case.
very short, short question. Actually, I'm from Ukraine. My name is Viktor Fursov. I have my personal website about nature and beekeeping. Would I ask if I can propose you for your organization to use part of my beekeeping technologies and my different stories about beekeeping to implement somewhere in a small place for your organization? Because many people from 50 countries watching me on my website, maybe some technology from Ukraine, not only mine, from different people in Ukraine, can be used somewhere in other countries. Can be very useful.
Yes, if your practices have been tested and have been validated, this is fine. Maybe even if they're only grateful or only useful for beekeepers in Ukraine or in the area, it's already provided that the information is available and stored for the long term. So yes, you can help.
Okay, thanks a lot. Well, you can send the emails or whatever to the contact email, where they can do it if it is possible. So we should move. Thanks a lot, Charlotte.